Match game 74. Production 0229. Take this. That's course I've been reading. Take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Louisa Moritz. Richard Dawson. And Kay Stevens. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Well, you got a very enthusiastic bunch here, and we thank you for joining us, and we thank you especially. We couldn't do it without you, because you're a very gifted, talented, crazy
bunch. We couldn't do it without you either, Jane.
Well, I thank you. The feeling is mutual.
We need you and your tie. We love your tie.
You need the tie.
I couldn't get along without
you. You're all ready, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, let's say hello to our players, Gloria Green and John Cashmere. Yay! Hi, Gloria. Gloria's a current champ. She's won $600, one game. And she's being challenged by John, who is ahead at the moment 5-0. And you've got your work cut out for you, because we're about to go to the second and final round. You have your question. You must match 5 celebrities to stay in the game. 6, however, will win the game. And we'll see how that turns out right after we see how this turns out. Hello there. Here we go now. I'll push a button.
Kick your slipper to the moon, Matilda.
I said the middle of round 2, but it's actually the second half of the tiebreaker. Is where we are at. Gloria, listen carefully. Everyone will play, and this is it. The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked a kangaroo. The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked the kangaroo. All right, you must write something. Richard Dawson made up his mind. I don't see why everybody can't be perfect
well,
like he
I made
is.
Up
no
my
one
mind.
Can be perfect like Richard. I've tried.
All right.
Look at me, darling. I've already
finished
my answer.
And the old Charles Nelson Reilly is...
I'm ready.
Okay. Now, Gloria Green, we call on you. The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked a kangaroo.
Cooked.
When he cooked a kangaroo. All right. 5 kangaroo roasted with sauce béarnaise will tie the score. 6 will win the game. Bert?
I said when he stuffed a kangaroo. Yes.
Stuffed a kangaroo. All right.
Very good stuff, Gino.
We need a cooked kangaroo from you.
I've
she's going to match
many
you.
Not only did he cook it, he took the baby in the pouch with him.
Oh, dear me. So there's one match. And Charles.
I could never let my dear friend Gloria down.
Cooked the kangaroo. All right. Okay, let's see what happens here with Louisa.
Well, I said if he cooked one, he wouldn't make headlines because he cooks frogs' legs and all these things. I said when he climbed into a kangaroo.
Hey, what have you got? You got a cooked kangaroo there. You got a cooked kangaroo. Oh, Gloria. Johnny Cosmaric wins the game. Come on down, John. Congratulations, John. Well, you missed tying the score there by 1, Gloria. It's been a pleasure doing business with you. We've got $600 for you. Together with our thanks for being with us twice on Match Game 74. Gloria Green.
Bye, Gloria.
Goodbye, Gloria. Okay, here we are with John, and if you're all set, John, we're going to have a go at a lot of money here, over $5,000 in the Big Money Super Match. You ready?
I'm all set.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, John, and we got their best response to this. Elliot Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250 and the bottom $100. 3 celebrities are allowed to help. You may choose them if you please, one at a time.
I'll start with Kay.
Oh, Elliot Ness.
Elliot Ness is her response. Another one.
Charles.
Elliot Gould.
Elliot Gould. Okay, one more.
Brett's writing furiously. Brett.
Brett, what do you say? Elliot Blank.
Oh, well, nobody remembers this person.
Well, whoever heard of Elliot Schwartz?
Except us oldies.
Go ahead.
What?
Elliot Nugent.
Elliot Nugent.
Well,
okay.
It's not funny. He has to be a perfectly marvelous playwright.
That's right. He wrote
The Male Animal.
That's right. It was a good play, The Male Animal.
Elliot Nugent.
All right, so you've got Elliot Nugent, Elliot Gould, and Elliot Ness. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Charles is right. I'm going to go with Gould.
Gould. Yay! Elliot Gould. Okay, so Elliot Gould is the one he's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Elliot Roosevelt.
Oh, my goodness.
Is that the one you thought of?
Yes, I thought of that.
Okay, still looking for Elliot Gould. Where are you? Are you under the $250 response? Elliot Ness is up there.
No,
all right.
One of Elliot Gould.
That was Kay's, right? Okay, let's see if... Here's your last chance, John. Looking for Elliot Gould. Here is the $500 response. Elliot Gould, you got it. Congratulations. Okay.
Nothing.
All right. Now, you've got the $500, John. You're going to be playing now for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. To collect, you must match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
I'm lucky with Charles. I'll go with Charles again.
All right. Dawes, you get ready to write. Would you face me, please?
I get very nervous.
All right. All right. And here we go. This is the $5,000 question, Charles. Hurry blank. H-U-R-R-Y. Hurry blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, John, we need a response from you. What would you say to match Charles in this? Hurry
up.
Hurry up. Hurry up. All right, Charles, for $5,000, may we see your answer? He says, hurry up, we'll match you.
I'm sorry I helped you.
Ta-da!
Ta-da! How do you feel?
Wonderful, wonderful. Now that I've got the money.
Yeah, you know how much you got? $5,600.
Yes,
what plans do you have for that money?
Well, pay off the house and then probably go to Vegas.
Be sure you do it in that order, John. All right?
Hurry on, hurry back,
hurry sundown.
Well, hurry home was the first thing that came to my mind. Yeah, that was very good.
Hurry
that
up.
Was a good win.
Thank
you. Okay, you're going to play another game
answer,
right after
darling.
We play another game with our audience in America. Here it is.
We have to introduce another player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Karen Lesko. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
You know John?
Yes, we do.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there? Lady has very pretty dimples in her cheeks.
Here we go. Now we're going to start another game. To do that, we're very pleased to present a new player. So let's welcome, with a great deal of warmth and affection, Karen Lesko. Karen, you know John? Somehow, Karen, I feel I know you very well. All right, now, Karen, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
I'm single. I work for the Los Angeles Police Department as an RTO. And
As a what?
An RTO, a radio telephone operator.
Oh.
I dispatch the calls.
You're the
to
one
the
that says,
officers.
One Adam 12,
right.
One Adam 12, ring it again, one Adam 12. I thought that was a bird that said that all the time. One Adam 12, that's all it says.
No, that's what I do.
Okay.
And I'd like to be a policewoman.
All right, good luck to you in that venture, and good luck here.
Thank you.
Shall we begin? I'll push the button, reveal two questions, and ask you, the challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is, and here we go, at long last. Stanley said, I crashed my car into the back of a circus van, and now I'm being sued for whiplash by a blank.
Oh!
Stanley said that I crashed my car into the back of a circus van. Now I'm being sued for whiplash by a blank.
I wish I were a better speller. I used to get A in spelling.
Spelling doesn't count here. It doesn't. We can figure it out.
I know, but it would be nice to be able to spell.
It would be, yes.
Just for self-pride.
That's right.
But, you know.
You're okay, Brett.
In the third grade, I could spell ton and tongue.
Really?
T-O-N.
Isn't that interesting?
Fascinating.
Karen, it's up to you now. Stanley said I crashed my car into the back of a circus van, and now I'm being sued for a whiplash by a...
Giraffe.
Yay! Now, she came up with a terrific answer. Yeah, the audience thinks that it's a terrific answer. So, Bert, watch it. I don't know what that means.
Don't put me under pressure.
No.
Well, actually, when you hit that van and it's full of animals, the one who is most likely to get a whiplash is the one with the longest neck, and I said giraffe.
Just like she did. Yay for Bert. Yay. Brett?
Hi there.
Hello.
Do you dye your hair?
What has that got to do with whiplash is what I want.
Well, I didn't say it, giraffe. I said contortionist, so I'm trying to get out of it gracefully.
Right. By picking on me.
A rotten answer. Charles?
I'm sorry, dear, but you had a great... I said acrobat.
An acrobat, yes.
Giraffe and was a terrific...
What do you say?
Well, I figured the nastiest temper, I said lion.
Lion would be very angry. So that's why you said that.
That's right.
Okay.
I didn't see any giraffes in the circus.
Do you know what whiplash is?
Yeah,
not my night, is it? What is whiplash?
That's when your neck goes the wrong way, like...
Okay. All right, Richard.
Would you show me that this side, please? How'd you go?
Can't do it that side.
I'll rest my case with the word giraffe, ma'am.
Okay. There's another one. How about you? You offering a little whiplash on that giraffe?
A little whiplash by the animal who has the best dimples. Giraffe.
Giraffe. That's three for you.
Yes.
Now, we've got this for you, John. Here we go.
Very good.
Richard Dawson eats pickles and peanut butter because he's blank.
Oh, I know that. That's easy.
Richard Dawson eats pickles and peanut butter because he's blank.
I still wish I
pickles and peanut,
peanut butter.
Butter. Yes.
I know what pickles and peanut butter are.
Charles. Pickles and peanut butter. May I not see yours? It's my show, after all.
Now watch that. Oh, I'll watch it then.
Pickles and peanut butter. All right. You may change your mind if you want. It's up to you entirely. You're on your own here. All right.
Washing machine?
Okay. Now, John, here it is. Richard Dawson eats pickles and peanut butter because he's...
No offense, because he's pregnant.
Why should he be offended because he's pregnant? It's a beautiful experience.
How in heaven's name would you know?
All right. He said pregnant. What
yes.
do you say?
Well, Gene would know because he and Dick were seen leaving the studio the other night. And I said pregnant as well.
Brett, what did you say?
Well, what I feel is that if he thinks he's pregnant, he's bloody well deranged.
Because he's deranged. Okay. Charles?
What did I you... said pregnant with hunger.
Okay. All right, Louisa.
I have no reason for this. I just said Jewish.
Jewish people are not noted for eating peanut butter.
I've been to a few Jewish delicatessens. They have a lot of peanut. They have a lot of pickles.
Yes, they do.
Big.
Okay. Well,
are
maybe he's half Jewish.
Jewish.
I don't know. Richard,
I know he's English.
When they do that.
Richard,
they have the Star of David glued to the top of their mouth.
That's right. That's it. Now,
I'm really surprised at that answer, sir.
You're surprised?
No, I just didn't think I was... you know, I thought I carried it very well. But I am with child.
Well, How did you handle this, Kay?
Oh, I felt his tummy tum tum, and it's definitely pregnant.
Okay. So at this moment, it's 4-3 at the end of round one, and we've got round two to go and a lot more, so you hurry back after this. We're ready to carry on here with round two. Scores 4-3 in favor of our current champion. And challenger, would you make a selection?
B again, please.
All right. Karen, you matched Richard Kay and Bert last time, so the three of you will not play. This is for the rest. After Selma married the surgeon, she said, "Every night it's just like an operation. The first thing he does is blank me." After Selma married the surgeon, she said, "Every night it's just like an operation. The first thing he does is blank me."
I'm trying to think of that word that means that. Oh. Hi, sweetheart. I mean, a person could go through life and never...
Just checking up on you, my dear.
You're so crazy about me, you can't see straight. Now,
that's
true. You've got to get over it.
True.
How old would Charles be if he lived?
Charles, are you ready?
I am ready, Doctor.
Okay. Now, Karen, it's up to you. After Selma married the surgeon, she said, "Every night it's just like an operation. The first thing he does is blank me."
Examines.
Examines me. Examines me is what she said. All right, Brett, let's see what you said.
That's what a gynecologist does.
Really?
But I'll tell you what a surgeon does.
What's he do?
He snaps his little body straight into the operating room and sterilizes you.
He sterilizes
you? So he can hack you to death.
Oh, I see.
Hope there aren't any doctors out there.
Charles, what did you say?
Anesthetize.
Anesthetize.
Wrong.
Okay. Well, now, you've got to match this lady to stay in the game, Karen. What do you say, lady?
I give up. I said he removes me. That's what it says.
He removes. So, John wins the game. Come on down. Congratulations.
Oh, I am, too.
Oh, Karen, I'm awfully sorry to see you go, Karen. It's been a pleasure meeting you. A very pretty lady. Isn't she a pretty lady there?
Thank you. Yeah. I had fun.
A gift for you backstage. Karen Esco, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. Now, John, you're going to have another go at the Big Money Super Match here. You've been here before. You know how it goes. And shall we get right to it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Let it blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. And 250 and 100 and all that. And, you know, you get a little help from the celebrities here.
Okay, we'll start with Kay.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Richard?
Present. Oh, the let Beatles it... song, Let It Be.
Let It Be. Okay.
Brett?
Brett?
Oh, I'm thinking of... I have two terrific answers that are bound to be winners. Okay, I'm thinking there were a lot of gamblers out there. I'm going to say Let It Ride.
Let It Ride. All right, you got Let It Ride, Let It Be, and Let It Go. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll take Let It Be.
Yeah. Let It Be. You're letting the audience influence you, aren't you?
I think they're a good group.
You think there's a good group out there? Okay. All right, we'll find out how smart that audience is. We're looking for Let It Be. May we see the $100 response? Let It Go is the one that Kay gave. Still looking for Let It Be. Here is the $250 response. Let It All Hang Out. Come back, Karen. Anyway. Okay, looking for Let It Be. May we see the $500 response? Let It Be! Congratulations. Very good, Richard. Okay. So, John, you've got the $500. That means you're going to have a go now 10 times that amount or $5,000. Which celebrity would you like to try to match on a head-to-head basis?
Kay.
Kay, ready?
Yes.
Okay, face me if you please, John. Here is the $5,000 question. Would you please write your answer to this? Father blank.
father.
Father blank. Or father blank. Okay, now she's finished, John. What would you say to match Kay in filling in that blank? Father
time.
Father time. Kay?
That was very good.
For $5,000, may we see your answer and see if he matched you?
I looked at you, Gene, and I thought father image.
Father image.
Sorry about that. You thought of that, too.
Okay, so you're up to $6,200, John, and you're still a champ. You're going to meet another player here. Here comes Teresa Negret. Hi, Teresa.
Hello.
Do you want to have a seat there, John? You know each other, do you?
Yes.
Good luck. Teresa Negretti, is that the way you say your name? You want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm married. I have two beautiful boys and a nephew that lives with me, and I'm starting a new job Monday in a food industry.
Okay, good luck there, and good luck when we start this game. We've got to take a break here right now and pass along this message to you, and then you come right back. Well, we just met this pretty lady, and now we've got to say goodbye to her, but momentarily. We'll get together next time. Our time is up, and we'll look forward to seeing both of you soon, and you too, soon.
Soon.
That is, next time, whenever it is. One never knows, you know. Is there anything anybody'd like to say? Well, there's no time for that either.
Things I'd like to say.
Gene Rabin for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
Over most of these CBS stations. Match Game 74. Production 0229. Take this. That's course I've been reading. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly, Louisa Moritz, Richard Dawson, and Kay Stevens, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rabin.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Well, you got a very enthusiastic bunch here, and we thank you for joining us, and we thank you especially. We couldn't do it without you, because you're a very gifted, talented, crazy
We couldn't
crazy
do it without
bunch.
You either, Jane.
Well, I thank you. The feeling is mutual.
We need you and your tie. We love your tie.
You need the tie.
I couldn't get along without
you. You're all ready, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, let's say hello to our players, Gloria Green and John Kashmiri. Yay! All right, Gloria.
Yes, Bob.
Gloria's a current champ. She's won $600, one game. And she's being challenged by John, who is ahead at the moment 5-0. And you've got your work cut out for you, because we're about to go to the second and final round. You have your question. You must match 5 celebrities to stay in the game. 6, however, will win the game. And we'll see how that turns out right after we see how this turns out. Hello there. Here we go now. I'll push a button.
Kick your slipper to the moon, Matilda.
I said the middle of round 2, but it's actually the second half of the tiebreaker. Is where we are at. Gloria, listen carefully. Everyone will play, and this is it. The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked a kangaroo. Bye, Gloria. Okay, here we are with John, and if you're all set, John, we're going to have a go at a lot of money here, over $5,000 in the Big Money Super Match. You ready?
I'm all set.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, John, and we got their best response to this. Elliot Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250 and the bottom $100. 3 celebrities are allowed to help. You may choose them if you please, one at a time.
I'll start with Kay.
Oh, Elliot Ness.
Elliot Ness is her response. Another one?
Charles? Elliot Gould.
Elliot Gould. Okay, one more.
Brett's writing furiously. Brett.
Brett, what do you say? Elliot Blank.
Oh, well, nobody remembers this person.
Well, whoever heard of Elliot Schwartz?
Except us oldies.
Go ahead.
What?
Elliot Nugent.
Elliot Nugent.
Well,
okay.
No, it's not funny. He has to be a perfectly marvelous playwright.
That's right. He wrote...
He wrote The Male Animal.
That's right. It was a good play. The Male Animal.
Elliot Nugent.
All right, so you've got Elliot Nugent, Elliot Gould, and Elliot Ness. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Charles is right. I'm going to go with Gould.
Gould. Yay! Elliot Gould. Okay, so Elliot Gould is the one he's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Elliot Roosevelt.
Oh, my goodness.
Is that the one you thought of?
Yes, I thought of that.
Okay, still looking for Elliot Gould. Where are you? Are you under the $250 response? Elliot Ness is up there.
No,
all right.
Elliot,
that was Kay's, right? Okay, let's see if... Here's your last chance, John. Looking for Elliot Gould. Here is the $500 response. Elliot Gould, you got congratulations. Okay.
Nothing.
All right. Now, you've got the $500, John.
All right. This lady has very pretty dimples in her cheeks.
Here we go. Now we're going to start another game. To do that, we're very pleased to present a new player. So let's welcome, with a great deal of warmth and affection, Karen Lesko. Karen, you know John? Somehow, Karen, I feel I know you very well. All right, now, Karen, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
I'm single. I work for the Los Angeles Police Department as an RTO. And
as,
I'd
a,
like
as a what?
An RTO, a radio telephone operator.
Oh.
I dispatch the calls.
You're the
to
one
the
that says, one Adam 12, one Adam 12,
right.
One Adam 12, ring it again, one Adam 12. I thought that was a bird that said that all the time. One Adam 12, one, that's all it says.
No, that's what I do.
Okay.
And I'd like to be a policewoman.
All right, good luck to you in that venture, and good luck here.
Thank you.
Shall we begin? I'll push the button, reveal two questions, and ask you, the challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is, and here we go, at long last. Stanley said, I crashed my car into the back of a circus van, and now I'm being sued for whiplash by a blank.
Oh!
Stanley said that I crashed my car into the back of a circus van. Now I'm being sued for whiplash by a blank.
I wish I were a better speller. I used to get A in spelling.
Spelling doesn't count here. It doesn't. We can figure it out.
I know, but it would be nice to be able to spell.
It would be, yes.
Just for self-pride.
That's right.
But, you know.
You're okay, Brett.
In the third grade, I could spell ton and tongue.
Really?
T-O-N.
Isn't that interesting?
Fascinating.
Karen,
biographical,
it's up to you now. Stanley said, I crashed my car into the back of a circus van, and now I'm being sued for a whiplash by a...
Giraffe.
Yay! Now, she came up with a terrific answer.
Yes,
the audience
did.
Thinks that it's a terrific answer. So, you're going to be playing now for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. To collect, you must match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
I'm lucky with Charles, so... Go with Charles again.
All right. Now, as you get ready to write, would you face me, please?
I get very nervous.
All right.
All right.
And here we go. This is the $5,000 question, Charles. Hurry blank. H-U-R-R-Y. Hurry blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, John, we need a response from you. What would you say to match Charles in this? Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. All right, Charles, for $5,000, may we see your answer. He says, hurry up, we'll match you.
I'm sorry I helped you.
Ta-da! Ta-da!
How do you
feel?
Wonderful, wonderful. Now that I've got the money.
Yeah, you know how much you got? $5,600. Yes, what plans do you have for that money?
Well, pay off the house and then probably go to Vegas.
Be sure you do it in that order, John. All right?
Hurry on, hurry back.
Hurry yeah. sundown.
Well, hurry home was the first thing that came to my mind. Yeah, that was very good.
Hurry
that was
up.
A good win.
Thank
okay,
goodness.
You're going to play another game right after we play another game with our audience in America. Here it is.
We have to introduce another player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Karen Lesko.
Hi, Karen.
Hi.
You know John?
Yes, we do.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there? The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked a kangaroo. All right, you must write something. Richard Dawson made up his mind. I don't see how why everybody can't be perfect
well,
like he
I
is.
Well, I made up my mind. Be perfect like Richard. I tried.
All right.
Look at me, darling. I've already
finished
my answer.
And the old Charles Nelson Reilly is.
I'm ready.
Okay. Now, Gloria Green, we call on you. The Galloping Gourmet made headlines when he blanked a kangaroo.
Cooked.
When he cooked a kangaroo. All right. 5 kangaroo roasted with sauce béarnaise will tie the score. 6 will win the game. Bert?
I said when he stuffed a kangaroo. Yes.
Stuffed a kangaroo. All right.
Very good stuff, Gino.
We need a cooked kangaroo from you.
I've
she's going to match
many
you.
Not only did he cook it, he took the baby in the pouch with him.
Oh, dear me. So there's one match. And Charles.
I could never let my dear friend Gloria down.
Cooked the kangaroo. All right. Okay, let's see what happens here with Louisa.
Well, I said if he cooked one, he wouldn't make headlines because he cooks frogs' legs and all these things. I said when he climbed into a kangaroo.
Hey, what have you got? You got a cooked kangaroo there. You got a cooked kangaroo. Oh, Gloria. Johnny Cosmonic wins the game. Come on down, John. Congratulations, John. Well, you missed tying the score there by 1, Gloria. It's been a pleasure doing business with you. We've got $600 for you, together with our thanks for being with us twice on Match Game 74. Gloria Green.